If there is a fountain of youth, it may be hidden on an island in the Mediterranean. Seth Doane goes in search of the secrets of Sardinia.
The scene at an Italian cafe may not seem remarkable until you know their ages. They're each 100 years old. And Guido Lepori says he's got years to go.
150.
Old age is common and celebrated in this town, where murals depict residents who've reached at least 100. Villa Grande is in Sardinia, a well-known destination for tourists who come for the culture and beaches. But it's also drawing scientists and gerontologists, including Johnny Pess and Walter Longo.
The whole world talks about this town. So we have 6 centenarians out of 2,000-3,000 people. Extremely rare anywhere in the world.
Longo directs the Longevity Institute at the University of Southern California and collaborates with Pess in studying this phenomenon of so many centenarians.
We are trying to find an explanation because after 20 years of hard work, we still don't have a clear explanation.
Villa Grande is a place where, after 63 years of marriage, one can still find Gabriele Mareu and his wife Ermelinda tending their garden.
Are you always this active? Siete sempre così attivi?
Sempre, no.
Always. I've always worked, this now 96-year-old told us. So has his cousin Vittoria. At 93, she's still hired by the Orlando Hotel to demonstrate the traditional way of making this bread, pistocco.
10% of people who are born in Villa Grande attain the age of 90.
10%?
10%. In Italy, it's 3%. So you can imagine it's more than 3 times higher than the national average.
Walter Longo thinks periods of fasting, for instance during wartime, followed by a richer diet with more protein and fat in later years, may contribute to longer lifespans. But meeting with those centenarians, he noted something else, the age of siblings.
How much of this is genetics versus lifestyle?
If you think about an athlete that wins lots of gold medals, you probably have to have the genetics, but then you have to have the training, et cetera, et cetera. So I think that the genetics set you up, but they're not going to get you there alone. And so then the lifestyle, and particularly the food, is a key factor.
Those lifestyle factors are on display. Living up in these mountains means regular exercise. And in town, community and family is important, particularly for Marietta Moni, who lives alone at 100.
Ha fatto Rita.
Ah. Rita made this.
We joined her for lunch made by family living in the apartment upstairs.
Buon appetito!
Buon appetito!
On the menu, pasta with tomato sauce. Historically, vegetables have figured prominently here.
Perfetto.
So has red wine.
Grazie.
Imbibed in moderation. Nearby at Giulia Pisanu's house.
Come sta lei?
Abbastanza bene per l'età che ho. Sto bene adesso quando ero giovane.
We asked this centenarian what she thought the secret to a long life might be.
Non essere gelosa.
Don't be jealous and don't be envious, she answered. Advice that may not be scientific, but like those celebrated on the walls here, comes from the perspective and wisdom of age.